Hi there, and welcome to The Works. I'm Ben Che.
And I'm Ben Peltier. Later on the show, the newly formed Wind Sextet Classics will be joining us to tell us more about their passion for wind instruments and about their repertoire, and introducing their upcoming concert, Wind Madness.
Our eyes contain two kinds of photoreceptors, rods, which detect dim light and are used for night vision, and cones, which detect color. If it's bright enough, the three types of cones enable us to perceive blue, green, and red, which combined make up thousands of colors. In some people, though, this perception of color is distorted, usually for genetic reasons. Red, green, and blue-yellow color blindness are usually passed down from parents.
Roughly 1 in 12 men and 1 in 200 women are said to be colorblind, a condition that affects more than 363 million people worldwide. But what happens when those affected are visual artists or designers, for whom color perception may be a vital part of their craft?
For most of us, perceiving the full range of colors in a work of art is not a problem. For artist Ernest Chang, that isn't the case.
I have a type of color blindness called deuteranopia. I can't see red and green very well. I can't tell colors like pink apart from gray, and then I can't tell orange apart from like brown, and then I can't tell purple apart from blue, stuff like that.
Unable to differentiate between red and green, Chang sees his work in different hues than most viewers. The shades of red and orange in his paintings may simply seem brown to him. While creating visual art might seem to require considerable sensitivity to color, Chang says his color blindness doesn't hinder him. He's developed the skill to distinguish between different hues.
For me, it's about the contrast between that color that I don't know with other colors that I know. So if I compare the color that I don't know to other colors that, let's say, a yellow that I can see or blues I can see, I can kind of guess if that color is something like pink or something that I can't see. So I would see gray, but then I know that it's pink. I have my assistant Ruby to help me. Ultimately, I can ask Ruby to color match with like Pantone catalogs.
When Chang first dedicated himself to working in a creative field, he tried working as a photographer. However, his color blindness led him to change disciplines from photography to painting.
I chose photography because I thought to myself, like, I want to use the colors that already exist in the world. But then I guess later on when I became more professional in my portraiture photography, I started getting a lot of clients, and they were saying that my skin tones were off a lot of times. And I decided that, you know, maybe it's time for me to stop with photography.
In Chang's recent series, Space Rich, he expresses to his love for outer space and the way it inspires his imagination. In some works, Chang places popular cartoon characters like Sailor Moon and the aliens from Toy Story in a surreal context. He also takes inspiration from surrealist René Magritte, reinterpreting some of the Belgian artist's works in his own way. The results are not intended just to be futuristic, but also to be a sardonic commentary on capitalism and consumerism.
It's a fallacy that we can leave human problems behind when we are the people creating these problems. And it's like, if you bring us to another planet, we're probably just gonna bring these problems with us and build it there. All the dust on Mars, all the dust on the moon are really dangerous for your lungs because they're so sharp. And so it is not for humans. And we act like, oh, this is plan B, but it's actually really not.
Born in Tampa, Florida, Chang moved to Hong Kong as a child. He didn't find growing up in the city easy. In the past, he's faced depression and addiction issues. For him, art is both an outlet and a companion.
When I was like 14 or, yeah, like a teenager, just I was struggling because I was dealing with my sexuality, and then I was also bullied a lot because of that. I think I had to go to the art room in order to kind of escape. And my art teacher was really nice, and she always supported me. And it was the only thing that kept me kind of going. Rehab taught me something really important was the art therapy. I felt like I got my emotion on something, on a piece of artwork, so that I can share it with other people. And that kind of drives me forward.
In 2014, Chang opened his hybrid gallery and studio, The Stallery, in Wan Chai's Stone Nulla Lane. He works, exhibits, and hosts events there.
But you have the gene.
Yeah, I know. I'm like, apparently,
they could be really lucky.
I get it from my grandma, apparently.
Yeah. Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay. I get it from my mom, my mom's side, yeah.
When he learned that his partner was planning to give him a pair of spectacles that compensate for color blindness for his birthday, he turned that idea into something bigger. He contacted the company that makes them to suggest a collaboration so that his gallery could lend the colorblind glasses to anyone who needed them when they came to view art. His is the first gallery in Hong Kong to do so.
I've never seen Hong Kong ever really talk about colorblindness in a way that kind of provides accessibility for everyone. And I feel like for me and for a lot of people that have colorblindness, they ultimately tell me that it is very difficult when they go to like art galleries and then they can't really see the nuances in, you know, landscape paintings.
Hey everybody, it's the big moment. One, two, three, put them on.
What?
Trying on the color-correcting spectacles for the first time, Chang experienced hues he had never seen before.
Oh my god, that's actually orange. It's so brown without it.
I think it's wonder. Like, that is my feeling right after I put it on. Like, just this sense of childlike wonder kind of came back. That's a three. Okay. That's a six. Yeah! Dude. I got normal.
I think, yeah, ultimately what I wanted is to raise some form of awareness that there is help if you do need this pair of glasses. You can definitely come here and try anytime you want.
In Franz Kafka's novella, Metamorphosis, the protagonist Gregor Samsa wakes up in his bed one morning to find himself transformed into a gigantic insect.
Inspired by this absurdity and the occasional surrealism of daily life, Leung Mee-ping's exhibition Souvenirs de Choses, meaning memories of things at Osage Gallery, uses seemingly trivial things, such as insects and dust, to ponder the weight of time.
Thank you.
Welcome back. Classics is a newly formed sextet, the core members of which are five wind musicians and a pianist. Their repertoire ranges from Baroque, classical, romantic, and 20th century classical music to rearrangements of pop songs. They're here right now to tell us about what they have in store for the local audience in their upcoming concert, Wind Madness.
Well, it's a pleasure here to have you guys in the studio. Frederick, Aaron, Tony, Winnie, and Lulu, welcome. You're five of the six members of Classics. What is it about the lineup that you've put together with Classics that allows you such a flexible nature where you can perform with four people, with three people, with five people, and with all six? What is it about the sort of lineup that you've put together that makes it this flexible?
For example, in the concert, first we begin with three people. We play Haydn, and then four people with Rossini, and then five people with Debussy, and then six people with Thriller. And for me, when I set up this ensemble, I think that this setting is very flexible because all of us are soloists. We play with piano, and sometimes me and Lulu and Viola, we can play Haydn, and we can play in many different events, and with many different instrumentation. It's not like first I thought about set up a quintet, but it's not so. When with piano, there's more harmony, so it's more combination. For me, this is the magic of our group.
Right, and I'm actually curious, Tony, as the non-wind player in this group, you're the one who's bringing something different to the ensemble. What is that experience like?
It's actually a little bit like similar to like playing with a string quartet. So they are a group by themselves. Wind quintet is actually a little bit different than a string quartet.
How so?
Because their string quartet is like essentially the, like one family of instrument, but wind quintet with brass, we have like different mechanic.
You're right.
Yeah.
Another interesting aspect of the woodwind quintet is always the fact that it includes the horn.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Yeah. And that's what I'm gonna say as well, because like I love having Tony here because he adds the thickness to our ensemble and also the variety of our like flexibility to adapt to playing like different musics or different genres. Like we also play pop musics as well, such as a Bohemian Rhapsody, which is like arranged by our good friend Fox. Yeah, it's a really great arrangement. And also we played some Chinese music as well. So I like the flexibilities of like six of us because some of us are actually studying, we're still students, and some of us are like teachings and doing concerts. And we come together because we have that magic together. And then we love making chemistries and making magic together.
Tell me a little bit more about the variety that you're able to do with this group.
For this concert, because I'm very scared when I go to the concert, I'm very scared of boring. I will sleep and I will leave. And so I designed the program that each piece is very different and I have different color. So the audience will really like it. It's not so classical in all the way, but every piece, the music communicates. And we like it, and we want to share our joy to the audience. That's what we thought about the program.
Frederick, I'd like to ask you, what is the favorite piece on the program coming up for you and why?
Actually, because it's like classics, it's like six people actually. I actually really like the wind quintet plus the piano music. So that's why I think this group is one of the like favorite group that I played together. And the piece we are playing is the Thriller Sextet. And that one actually is also one of my favorite sextet piece. And it has a lot of nice melody in each movement. Sometimes maybe some music, some movement might sound a bit boring than others, but I think this one is every movement has its own color and has its own sparks, and I think I like it a lot, yes.
Lulu, I'll turn to you for the last question. We have five people here in the studio, but that doesn't necessarily mean with this group, as we've discussed, that you'll perform as this lineup. What piece would you like to play for us here in the studio?
we are going to play the Wind Quartet by Rossini, the first movement of it. We choose this piece because it showcases different instruments' colors, because as we said, we have different kind of instruments, and we would love to showcase the different colors, the tone colors of it. So this piece have different solos of us. So I think this piece can show our instruments' colors, and also it is a very classic and standard piece.
Marvelous. I'm looking forward to it. Thanks so much for coming in.
Thank you. Thank you.